boarding school when he was very young. As a matter of fact, unlike myself and my sister Selma, who were always living at home in a close family atmosphere, Nesuhi spent many years away at school. When my father was appointed ambassador in Washington in 1934, we all moved to America, but Nesuhi opted to stay in Europe, continuing his studies in England and in France. It was in 1939, when the Second World War started, that Nesuhi returned to the family in Washington. In the following years, he became a major influence on me. He came back from Paris with an enormous enthusiasm about literature, art, music, and especially about the avant-garde in those fields. He had been imbued with the intellectual and artistic worlds of Paris of the 20s and the 30s, and he opened for me many new windows. He taught me about art, philosophy, international politics, and of course about his greatest love, Black American music. He was intellectually advanced well beyond his years and had a great sense for creative research, and the joy of discovery. In the field of jazz, this led us to put together a tremendous collection.